So welcome to NX for Manufacturing Tech Tips. Today's tech tip is titled, How to Create and Manage an NC Work Package. Demonstration will last approximately 20 minutes. I'll stay on the line and open up a chat window for questions and answers. With that, I'll turn the session over to Dave Madeley. Welcome, Dave.
Thank you very much, Derek. Good morning, everybody. Basically, what we're going to do is try to explain to you what we at Siemens think of as a work package. So a work package to us is really a container in PLM, which holds all the information that you need for your manufacturing process, for your manufacturing step. It's a way of providing context and bringing all the information together. It's not new data. It's data, it's information that is created by all manufacturing companies today. It's the CNC, NC programs, it's the work instructions, it's all that good stuff. It's data that you have to create today in order to actually go down to your shop and drive your machines. And fundamentally, if you think of it as taking the part that you want to manufacture, the what, you as an NC programmer work out how you're going to make that part. You decompose it into the different steps, the individual NC programs, the different operations. So you work out the how, you work out the where, you know, which machines you're going to use, and you work out which tools you're going to use, using what. When you've created those NC operations, those NC programs, you then typically have to manage them and put them somewhere. And a native customer, someone using just NX, would probably have a file system or a folder structure, like the one indicated on the right, where they actually manage all of their data. So, for example, the CAM files, the actual NX part files, they may put into a specific machine folder in a specific CAM files folder. The actual NC programs, the post-process code would go into an NC programs folder. And these would all be potentially pushed into pushed and duplicated into a DNC solution, for example. Or maybe other systems that give this information down to the shop floor would read from this folder structure. So, as we said, it's not data, it's not new data. The concept of an NC package within PL, within Siemens, is really just about taking data that you have today, that you manage in a different process today, and making it more usable, making it more available. So again, if we think about managing work packages, today when we use NX, we create our NC programs. We store the NX part files into this folder structure. What we're talking about really, when we talk about our concept of work packages, is really replacing that folder structure with a PLM environment that can sit there in the background as a back office application almost, and provide this mechanism for vaulting and controlling and managing this data. From that PLM environment, you can then interface to the shop floor. You can get information down to the shop floor, or you can take information and you can push it out to other systems like ERP. You can, for example, connect a DNC system to PLM. But really, the primary thing is that you've got to manage that information first. You've got to put all that information into one place and have it in a controllable, version control managed environment. And this is the idea behind a work package. So a work package to us, typically we think of a work package as being a step in a process. So we think of a routine or a process as being a technical package, and every product that you make would normally have a technical package, i.e. a routine and a series of steps, and some of those steps would be CNC steps. So we think of the process as being the technical package, and then the individual steps within the process as being the work packages. And it's these individual work packages that we would load into NX and author within NX. So the contents of the work package really are everything that you need in order to execute that particular stage or step. So it could be manufacturing data, it could be, you know, details of measurements that need to be made, it could be standard engineering documents or quality documents, equipment that's required, resources like cutting tools, quality information, everything that needs to be stored against that step to make it easy for the person that's going to execute that step to see the information is really what we deem as the contents of the work package. This is where we want to bring it all together. The other thing that's very important is when you're dealing with work packages, when you're moving from this native use of the NX tool to a managed, what we call the manage mode of NX, whereby instead of reading from the operating system, it's actually reading from the PLM environment. We want the user experience to be as similar as possible to how NX works in native mode. So the key takeaway from this session is that using NX in manage mode shouldn't be any more complicated than using native NX. There isn't extra work that needs to be done just because you're in manage mode. All the information that you create today and store in your directory structures is stored inside the PLM environment, but the actual creation of that data, the interaction with the system, etc., can all be done through NX. We don't need you to go and become a Teamcenter user and learn new interfaces. Everything to allow you to create managed work packages can be done from the NX UI. The NX environment gives you the capability to look at everything you've created, open it, review it, etc. And obviously once you've created it and saved it, it's in the PLM environment, it's managed. You've got one single source of that data and you get all the benefits of system managed manufacturing data. Okay, so what we aim to do today is, in a brief 10-15 minute demonstration, just introduce you to using NX in this manage mode and help you to understand how technical packages are created and how they're managed within the PLM environment, and to go and look at the benefits of this and help you to understand why this is a good thing. So I'm going to move over to the application and I'm going to give you a brief introduction. Okay, so hopefully everyone can see my desktop. I'm going to start NX in manage mode. What you'll see is it's just a double click on the icon. NX starts, but because I'm in manage mode, I have to enter some user credentials. So all the open and close and the file interaction is going to be between the PLM environment and NX. There isn't any information that's coming from the operating system. So I enter my username and password, give the system a few seconds to launch NX in manage mode. And the first thing you'll see when NX comes up is that it's the normal standard NX environment, but there's some subtle differences. So wherever we would normally do a file open or a file save, you'll actually see in a moment that we're connecting to the database and we're actually opening and closing from the PLM environment. So NX 8.5 is the version that we're working with, but this is the same behavior for previous versions of NX. This capability to run in manage mode has been there for a while. You'll notice because we started in manage mode, we've got this new icon down the left-hand side, which is the Teamcenter Navigator. And this is effectively your window into the PLM environment. So I logged in as Mike, and what it's done is taken me to Mike's home area. So I can now look at the different folders that are in this home area. I can see all the different kinds of information. I can have folders that are common. So I can have a common structure and I can have administrative folders where everybody can write to the same folder. So immediately we've got this capability to create shared folders, to create group folders. We can create all of our users and we can let them log into the environment and see this data. What I'm going to do is open some product data. So this is the part that we're going to look at today. I can find this part and just say open. And NX will load this model from the database. So this is a component that's been loaded from the database, a design part. Now, the first thing that you'll notice is that this is all very straightforward. There isn't a drastic change to the UI. This is the NX that you're familiar with. But when we start to look at the manufacturing, so if I go to the manufacturing module, what you'll notice is that it looks into the PLM environment and sees that there's already three work packages being created. So you remember in that PowerPoint slide, we saw that we got the part that we wanted to make, the what. And then we talked about the how, the where, and the with what. Well, we've already created three work packages, three different CAM machining setups, and the system knows that these three setups, these three work packages are related. So I could, for example, open one of these. So again, the system goes, finds all that information, loads up that setup, and you can see that we're in CAM. We're working as if we would normally work in CAM. The subtle difference, again, is that when we retrieve from library, whenever we bring a tool into the system, it comes from the PLM environment. So if we look in the geometry view or in the machine tool view, the cutting tools that we're bringing in are coming from the PLM environment. If we create a new cutting tool, we can retrieve from library. And these tools are coming from the database, from the PLM environment. So these tools are actually existing back in PLM. The machines, etc., are back in PLM. And the post-processors can even be back inside PLM if that's how you want to operate. So this is the main difference. The other thing that you'll see is if we close this part, and if we open this guy again and go to manufacturing, if we open a part that's not got a machine and that's not got any CAM created, what we can do quickly is just show the data that gets created. So let's create a tool. Let's pick a milling tool from the library. And let's take this guy. So here we've got a tool being brought in. Put that tool to a pocket. We can go to our geometry view and we can select the workpiece that we want to machine. And we'll create a simple operation. Here we'll just do a quick operation on the top face. Pick the tool. So here we've just got a toolpath. What I really want to show you is that when we retrieved the tool, we picked a tool from the library, we created an operation. When we actually save this now, so this is op 2 rough machine side 2. When we look back at our Teamcenter and we look at op 2 rough machine side 2, which is this, we look at revision A, what you can immediately see is that under the manufacturing occurrences, the system understands which tool's been added. So as you create your NXCAM, as you build your CAM program, the PLM environment knows which tools you have brought into the system, which tools you've retrieved from the library. If we take this if we take this operation and we actually do some post-processing, we pick the mill 3 axis and post-process this, we could pick a simple shot dock, take a tool list, create it. We know we've only got one tool, but we get the shot dock created. When we actually save this information again, what you'll see is that the system knows that there's a work instruction created, the tool list work instruction. It knows that there's been some post-processing created, so it actually knows there's an NC program, and it prompts us to import that data. And again, once this is saved, if we go to this Teamcenter Navigator and we look underneath this operation, what you'll see now is that we've actually got information created. We know the tool list is there. We can see the G&M code, and I can just right click from this, open it, and here's the work instruction that was saved directly from NX into the database. If I stand on the G&M code program and open it, here's the posted output. So all of this information is being managed. All of this data is being saved back into the database and managed in the context of this work package. And this work package has got a version. So what we can see when we look under this work package that we were just working on, this is the top level work package, but we're working on revision A of this work package. We can see all the details about when it was created. We can see the information about who owns it, who was the last person to change it, etc. And the great thing is that all of this is in the database. So this work package could be pulled out by a DNC system and pulled down to the shop floor, and all of that content beneath it can be served to the point where it needs to be consumed. The other thing that we can do is in this environment is, for example, we can think about our work instructions. Again, you know, if we create a new drawing. So if we choose to create an A3 drawing, we can give it a name. So this is setup 2, sheet 1. We know we've got to give instructions and details to the guys on the shop floor. So if we hit OK, to draft in. Here's the template. We could populate some information about this. We could say that first issued by myself. Okay, which populates this. We can pick a specific view. Take this. And we can create draftings, and those drawings will actually get managed and stored in the database against the NC work package that's been created. So the drafting, the actual drawing, will be stored as a specification. So here's one that we created on this first operation. Here's the drawing specification. And again, we close all parts. We can open this directly from the Teamcenter Navigator. And we can see that drawing that was created. We can see the view of the machine. So this is stored in the context of the work package and can be automatically converted into a CGF or a PDF once it's in the database and delivered down to the shop floor as work package content that can be read by the guys on the shop floor that are actually stood at the hardware. The other thing that really is key that we have to bear in mind is that once the information's in the database, these individual versions of the work package can be submitted to a workflow. So we can actually release the content of this, we can give it status. And again, we don't need to do that using a Teamcenter client. We don't need anyone to use a new UI. we can actually release these work packages using the shop floor system, and we'll cover that in our upcoming tech tip, where we talk about how we can take these work packages and leverage this content down to the shop floor. So what I'm going to do is just briefly talk about some of the benefits of this. So as we said, this was a very brief introduction into using NX in manage mode and showing you how technical packages are created and how the work packages, the individual steps, are created. The benefit of managing your work packages, you're using NX. It's a very familiar UI. There isn't a drastic amount of change. There's a very simple transition for an existing NXCAM user to move to managing their data in this way. It's a very simple concept of work packages. It's just really a context object. It's what we call an operation step, and we just hang all of the information beneath it, and we have a relationship from that operation step to the part that you're making. So from the part, you can see all of the work packages that are related to it when you're in that Teamcenter Navigator. The benefit of it being in the database, it's a single source of data. You don't get duplication, you don't get issues with incorrect versions, you know everything about that data, when it was edited, who did it. You've got all the traceability and the robustness of a life cycle for the manufacturing data. You can status it, you can release it, you can make it available to other systems. And it provides a very scalable platform for additional manufacturing apps. Shop Floor Connect for Teamcenter, the capability to take these work packages down to the shop floor is something we'll cover in an upcoming session. And a big thing to remember is this is not new data. All of the data that we create, all the data that we talked about managing today, is data that you create already, that you in your manufacturing systems. It's data that you need in order to drive the machines. What we're offering here is just a new way of managing that data and archiving it away and leveraging it from a robust management system instead of a folder structure or duplicating it into multiple systems. So with that, I'd like to thank you very much and open up the chat for questions. Derek, hand back over to you.